Welcome, my name is Jason Johnson and thank you for watching this video. I hope you find all of my videos helpful and thank you for subscribing to my channel. If you have any questions or feedback for me, you can leave a comment below and I'll answer as quickly as possible or try to point you in the right direction. This video is going to be over Chapter 3, Part 1 of 3. So there's going to be three parts for Chapter 3. This is Part 1. Parts 2 and 3, the links will be in the description below. And Chapter 3 is going to cover computer assembly. So let's get started with our video or with our first part here, and that's going to cover assembling the computer, building the computer. And again, parts 2 and 3 will be in the links will be in the description below. Now, when we're assembling the computer, the first thing that you're going to do is work with the case and the power supply. And when you open your case up, you want to check and make sure that all of your parts are there. When you buy a new case from a manufacturer, you're going to receive the case and you're most likely going to get a package of screws that go with the power supply to maybe put the motherboard down or maybe some other miscellaneous screws that go with it. You just want to check and make sure that you have everything there. You're going to make sure you prepare your space. You know, there's some cables in there. I know this is a small photo, but if you were in the lab for the NETACAD course, you're going to see videos that show you how to do that. And I'm also going to do some videos later on, and I'll put links in the description below at a later time on actually assembling a computer. But you're going to open your case up, and there's different methods for opening your case up. You don't want to force anything and break anything. Some modular cases, and a Dell or an HP, they have some latches and things like that that open up a case, so you just want to make sure that you're opening that up properly. If you're not sure, just consult maybe with the manufacturer online or check out a YouTube video that will show you that. But you want to check the manufacturer's documentation to make sure everything goes in that case. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to install the power supply. Now, the power supply most likely will come with the case. Those are usually sold as a bundle when you purchase those from a manufacturer, just because it makes it easier to buy the case and the power supply at the same time. And in some cases, those are already pre-installed inside the case. But if they are not, or if it is pre-installed, you want to make sure that the screws are tightened down because those can come loose in shipping. So you want to make sure that that's all tightened down properly. You want to check inside and make sure that you can put your power supply in properly. And I want to give a word of caution here on working inside the case. You want to be careful when moving your hands around inside the case because there are sharp metal objects and you can slice your fingers open or slice your hand open. I have done that in the past, so you want to be careful with that. And you're just going to secure the power supply. You're going to put it in where it belongs. You know, let's say that it's going to go right inside there. And you're going to have four screws on the back side of the case. And you want to put those screws in. You don't want to put each one in and tighten it down. You want to put all four screws in partially or most of the way. I would say about 90% of the way. And then make sure that your power supply is seated properly. Make sure that the cables are out of the way. And then tighten those down all the way at the end of it. You want to, that way you don't bend something or get something moved out of shape. So you want to basically tighten those down about 90 to 95% of the way and then go back after you get all four of them in and tighten them all down. And then you want to make sure that they're all tightened properly. On the PowerPoint here, it says use a cable tie to secure the cables out of the way. I don't really use a cable tie to move them out of the way. Sometimes I use a Velcro strap to move them out of the way, but in most cases, I just lay them out of the way. I don't tie anything down at this point because I have other things to put in, and I want to make sure that my cables are able to stretch to the right locations. So after we get the power supply put inside the case, the next thing that we're going to do is we're going to install the CPU, the heatsink, and the fan assembly. So you're going to install the CPU, but before you do that, and before you start picking up any parts, you want to be very careful about electrostatic discharge. And in previous videos, I've talked about ESD and how little electrical static being discharged can really devastate or destroy a piece of electronics. So you want to make sure that you're using a wrist strap and also that you've got a mat. Some people will tell you that you can do just a mat or just a wrist strap, but if you're wanting to be very cautious, you want to lay the mat out. That little alligator clip right there, it's on that end right there. You're going to tie that to the K case, a metal part of the case. You're going to clip that on so that any electrostatic discharge is going to go into the case and it's going to dissipate. It's not going to go into the electronics piece. So you want to use a strap. You want to use a mat. You can use both of them. Some people will tell you that you can use either or. And I've watched a lot of people where they never even use any of them. And you may handle electronics 100 times. And on that 101st time, you may get an electric discharge and or get some discharge and destroy that piece of equipment. And if you've just spent a couple hundred dollars on a CPU, you don't want to have to have that not work, because that's just going to make you have a bad day. So make sure that you are properly grounded. You want to use the markings on the CPU and motherboard to align and install the CPU based upon which type of socket you have. You want to make sure that you don't force anything. All of the CPUs can only go in one direction, and there's usually going to be some corner piece that you can tell. There's going to be you can look at, like, here you can see like a corner piece there, and you can look on the other side of the CPU and see which side goes in. You want to make sure that you're not forcing anything. You don't want to hear any crunching or anything like that, or any pops. Again, you don't want to force anything. You just put it in nice and easy. You also want to make sure that you're putting in thermal paste or thermal compound in between your CPU and your heat sink. So when you go to put your heat sink in, you need to have that heat that's going to be generated by the CPU to be transferred to the heat sink. And you want to make sure that you have the proper amount of thermal paste on there. You don't want to have too much, because you don't want to have it gooping up all over your motherboard. But at the same time, you want to have enough so that that heat is transferred properly. Okay, so we have opened our case, we've put our power supply in, we've put our CPU, our heat sink, and our fan assembly in. We're next going to talk about installing the RAM. And when we go to install our RAM in our computer, random access memory, you want to make sure that you're putting that in the right way. It's also very sensitive to ESD, so you want to be careful about handling that. You don't want to put your fingers on the gold tips. You do not want to get your all humans have grease or some type of we all have grease on our hands, whether we think we do or not. We can go wash our hands, but we still have grease on them. So some people use special gloves to wear when they put on there. You want to make sure they're not using like cotton gloves or things like that, but there's special gloves that you can buy to handle electronics. I've never used gloves before, as you can see in the previous picture that we've got over here. Let me go back to the previous slide here. There's special gloves that you can use. You can do that. I've never used gloves, and I've never had a problem as long as I'm properly grounded, but you could do that. But your RAM is only going to go in one direction, so you want to make sure that you're putting it in properly. You want to make sure that you consult the motherboard manufacturer, make sure that you're putting it into the right slots, and you want to push it in. You are going to have to apply some pressure to get it to be pushed down in, but at the same time, it's not going to be that bad. You know, you push it in and get it to click in. And then you're going to install your motherboard. Your motherboard is going to only go in one direction into your case, and you're going to have specific screws that go in specific spots. You want to consult the manufacturer's information on where those screws go. You do not want to over-tighten those, and you don't want to tighten them down one at a time. You want to put all of the screws in first. And what I do is I go ahead and put all my screws in, and I get them about 90 to 95% of the way tightened down. And then after they're all installed and I make sure everything is got the proper clearance and it's setting in properly, then I go back through and tighten them all up. And then you're going to make sure that your I/O connectors are at the back of the computer that are lined up properly as well. Okay, so after we get our motherboard installed, we are going to install the internal hard drives. And depending upon which hard drive you put in, you may be putting in a 5.25, or you may be putting in a newer SSD drive. Depending on if it's a smaller SSD drive, you might have to have some kind of case or some kind of you will have a metal clip that comes over this that comes down and maybe comes down a little bit, that's got screws down here, so that you put your SSD inside that that case, and then it's going to slide in. And then here you're going to slide that in. There's a screw hole there and a screw hole there. And then you slide that in, put your screws in. Some computers have modular clips, so you put the clips on, and then you slide it in, and it just clips right in. It makes it easy to pull in and out. But you're going to put that in one way so that you can have your connectors are going to be able to be accessed to your cables. And then you're going to install your optical drives. If you're going to put a DVD in or a Blu-ray drive, a Blu-ray reader and maybe a DVD writer, you're going to install those in. And that's going to go in a particular spot. Those usually go at the very top of a tower case. but you can kind of move those around depending upon your case. And that's going to be some kind of personal preference where you put that at the very top or maybe put that at the bottom. But you want to make sure that your cables do reach to that. Okay, so we have installed our CD-ROM, we've installed our SSD, and now we're going to put in our adapter cards. Depending upon what you're going to be doing, whether you're going to be putting in a FireWire card for doing video recording, or you're going to put in an extra USB card, external or internal card to be able to have extra USB inputs, or whether you're going to put in a TV tuner or something like that, that's really going to consult the manufacturer depending on which slot you're going to put that in, whether it's going to be in the PCI or the PCIe slot. Those are the two most common that you're going to put in, and most of them are PCIe. And you're just going to put those in, make sure that you take off the extra spacer in the back of the computer, the computer case, and then put that in. If you're going to put a wireless NIC card in, most desktops are going to put in some type of wired NIC card or network interface card. But if you do put a wireless in, you're going to put that in. Sometimes those have an antenna off the back of it. You're just going to find the right slot for that. And then you're going to put that in. You're going to install your video adapter card if you have an extra video card. A lot of motherboards have internal video cards or built-in video cards, but gamers and people that do like what I do with a video recording, I have a video card in mind that's an AGP, well, an older AGP. Now I've got a PCI Express, and I want dual monitors. So I've got a video card with dual DVI coming out the back, and so I put in an extra video card that has dual DVI coming out of the back. So I put that in, and then I had to just a side note of caution. Sometimes you have to go into the BIOS and disable the onboard motherboard or the onboard video that's on your motherboard so that your video card will work. Now, after we've done that, we're going to connect everything up to the motherboard. The motherboard does require power to operate, so you're going to connect your power supply into your motherboard. The motherboard relays power to other components in the adapter cards. You're going to refer to your motherboard documentation to make sure that everything's compatible, that your right power supply is going where on there. You're going to align the proper connectors, press it down into the motherboard. It does take a little bit of pressure, you know, when you're pushing it down right in there, and it's only going to go one way, so make sure that you're lining it up properly so you don't want to break anything. And also, I sometimes put my finger underneath the motherboard so that I don't push down too hard and crack the motherboard. You don't want to put too much that you're breaking the motherboard, but at the same time, you have to apply a little bit of pressure. So it can be difficult. So if it's not going in properly and it's not, you know, you're having to push too hard, then something's wrong. Stop and check it, but don't use force on it, or don't use too much force on it. And now you're going to connect your power to your internal hard drives, your case fans, you know, whether you have a Molex connector or your 15-pin SATA connectors, you're going to put all those in. You're going to align the proper connections. You're going to need, you know, hook your fans up and make sure that those have proper power so that you have a good cooling to your computer case. And then you're going to connect your internal data cables. You're going to go to your SSD drives, your regular drives. You're going to install the front panel cables. That's your power supply button, your USB connectors that come off the front of the case, and you're going to connect those to the motherboard as well. And then you're going to reassemble the case. You're going to put the sides on. What I usually do is leave one of the sides off or the main side off. I don't close my case back up until I make sure everything is working. I go ahead and leave my case off because I don't want to have to put it on. I forgot to connect something properly and then take the case back off. So just as a side note, that's just what I've done in the past. I have I leave the case off or the side of the case off until I know everything is working properly. You just want to make sure all your cables are connected. Make sure if you've connected any USB, make sure that your video cables are connected properly. And then boot it up. And then you're going to go to the next stage after that, which is booting the computer and the BIOS and the UEFI settings. And the next video, which will be part two, will cover that. So this is the end of part one. I hope hope it was helpful for you. And if you have any questions or comments or feedback, just leave those in the comments below. And I hope you have a great day.